Hmm. Yes. These do lead the way to a definite truth. Looking at the location of the bruise, the tip of the screwdriver must have pierced Dennis's lung. His lung would then rupture, causing pulmonary emphysema, and he would have suffocated. This explains the spots of hemorrhaging in the corpse's eyes. What actually happened that day is slowly coming to light now. These two can tell us how the murder happened. On the day of the incident, the killer came to the victim's room and stabbed him in the torso. The murder weapon was... Yes, the screwdriver pierced the victim's lung, causing pulmonary emphysema. This caused respiratory problems due to lung failure. Thus, the cause of death was... After this, the killer moved the victim to the bed. This is most likely because... Indeed. The murderer then arranged the corpse to make the death appear to be a suicide. That is what I believe took place, according to the evidence we have gathered. It's true then. This does have to do with the victim. But I wonder why. I get the feeling that there's something very wrong about this. Indeed. At first glance, it doesn't seem like these refer to the same person at all. On the one hand, drug-dealing scum enjoying his life. On the other, a man with suicidal depression. Either one of these clues is false, or there's more to this shady business that I haven't found out. In either case, the truth of the matter is that he was indeed a drug dealer. Something missing that should be here. If the puncture wound in the abdomen was the true cause of death, right, there should be blood stains and a hole where the screwdriver went through his clothing. Thank you. Yes, these pieces of information can tell us something. According to Mr. Taylor's friend, on the day of the incident, Dennis had been wearing... That's right. He was supposedly wearing a red Portland Jacks t-shirt that day. But when his body was discovered, it was wearing... Yes. His corpse was found wearing a white shirt. In other words, his clothing had changed. And yet, if that was all we know, we couldn't rule out if the deceased had changed his shirt himself. However, if he had, there would still be a discrepancy. Yes. The corpse had a wound that wasn't reflected by the state of the clothing it was wearing. There's only one answer to this puzzle, and that is... Indeed. Whoever had killed Mr. Taylor replaced the shirt he was wearing after killing him. The reason for doing that was... Exactly. It was probably to hide the stab wound and make us believe the cut wrist was the cause of death. The killer staged the suicide in order to mislead us. I see. These two are related. There are no vital reactions to the broken finger. That means the damage occurred after death. Considering that the killer must have changed the victim's clothing after death. That's right. The killer broke the corpse's finger while changing the shirt on the body.
Dr. Kimishima, how's the investigation going?
I've almost uncovered the deception, but the truth hasn't completely been revealed.
I see. So we can't arrest the culprit yet?
That's right. I need conclusive evidence that can help us identify the killer.
The most reliable giveaway would be if we could find a fingerprint at the crime scene. However, only the victim's fingerprints were found when HQ searched the room.
I'm not surprised, considering the lengths the killer's gone to hide his tracks. The murderer was probably wearing gloves while the crime was being committed.
Isn't there anything the killer might have touched?
Something that would require him to take his gloves off? It's hard to think of anything.
Best evidence would be on a hard, slick, inorganic substance. It doesn't matter what size it is.
All we can investigate are the crime scene, the corpse, and what the corpse was wearing. Could there be anything among those items that the killer touched with a bare hand? I'll have to investigate further. Thank you, little guy.
Thank you.
put this shirt on the victim's corpse after the murder took place. That would mean that the killer would have had to button the shirt up as well. Buttoning up a shirt with gloves on is no easy task. If my predictions are correct,
on the victim's clothes, huh? I'll look into them right away. One moment, please.
Hopefully this will help us find the identity of our mystery murderer.
Dr. Kimishima, it was there. I found it. There's a fingerprint from someone who isn't the victim. It's, a right thumb.
Great. Run the print through the list of registered offenders immediately.
Leave it to me. Such an attention to detail has gone into this, it can't possibly be a first-time offender. There has to be a match for this fingerprint in our records.
I sincerely hope so. This case should be over soon. The dead shall speak. Let's put together the truth of what happened here. The victim in this case is 30-year-old Dennis Taylor. As there's no motive for murder, it's a suspected suicide. However, the victim had a hidden other side. This card is the one with proof of that. Yes. While he did work at the bar, he also dealt drugs. This case is related to the victim's drug activities. The proof of that is on this card. Indeed, the drugs hidden behind the shelf were missing. The killer went into Taylor's room to kill him for his drugs. The real cause of the victim's death can tell us that. I know that because of this card. Right. The wound on the wrist was not the true cause. Next, the killer disguised the murder as a suicide. This card proves the misdirection used to hide the murder. Yes, the appearance of suicide covered up the real cause. The next topic is the secret hidden in the room itself. The murderer used a trick to create a locked room mystery. It was made to seem as if the victim was the only one there. This card shows the trick that had been used. Exactly. The killer thought this would clear his trail. And yet, the culprit had one more way to hide from suspicion. That was to hide when the murder itself took place. This card shows how he went about that ruse. The murder took place 3 hours prior to the fire's start. It's natural to assume that if the room was locked, then the crime and the fire would be at the same time. The plan was perfect. No fingerprints were left in the room. However, there was one thing the killer hadn't counted on. There was one task he needed to remove his gloves to do. This card is evidence of that task. He probably couldn't button the clothes with his gloves on. No matter how small the buttons, they were still prints. Even a fragment of a fingerprint can be used to identify him. The victim must have been surprised. After all, he thought the killer was a customer. This is what he said at the very end. Final flickers of this soul's light show me the truth. Who's there?
I'm sorry. I must have surprised you.
You're that electrician. Why are you here?
I was called up because a switchboard blew. I need to have it fixed by tomorrow.
I see. That sounds difficult. Freeze. Don't move. I see corpses all day. One more won't bother me.
Naomi! You hurt. I'm sorry. I should have stayed.
I've solved the case. I'll give you my report tomorrow.
The report can wait. Naomi, you must think of your safety.
Nobody lives forever. Even if I died today, it'd just be earlier than I expected.